Hello everyone, today we will review the Bambu Lab A1 Combo 3D printer. Bambu Lab has changed a lot in the 3D printer industry. This is a fact. From my observations, other 3D printer brands are trying to catch up with them and are developing printers with features similar to Bambu. Of course, not all of them, but most of the popular brands are doing this. I previously reviewed Bambu's high-end printer, the X1 Carbon Combo, and found the printer to be very successful. For those who are curious and haven't watched it yet, you can find the link to that review video in the tag above and in the video's description section. Usually, brands first release their economical and entry-level 3D printers. Then they start producing high-end printers. However, with Bambu Lab, it's the opposite. After producing high-end and mid-range printers like the X and P classes, the more affordable A1 and A1 mini models were introduced. Today, I will review the A1 combo model, for which I have high expectations due to the previous models. Now let's start by technical specifications of the printer. Then we will continue with the sample prints I have taken. The A1 features a simple and elegant design unique to Bambu. Matte aluminum is used in the Z and X axis profiles, while the main body is made of white plastic. The printing head has a direct drive extruder system, and this system moves along a linear rail. A flexible build plate with a PEI coating is used as the printing bed. Optionally, you can also integrate a flat PEI, dual textured PEI, bamboo high temperature bed, or effect beds. On this printing bed, you can make A1 prints with a width, depth, and height of approximately 256 mm. Bed leveling is completely automatic and also very precise. The pressure-sensitive nozzle performs precise measurements at multiple points, leaving you with no leveling tasks to handle. Although the printer does not have a LiDAR sensor, it can measure accurate flow with the extruder system. This helps you achieve better surface quality and better tolerance in your printing. The A1 is a fast 3D printer, and in my opinion, one of the essential features for fast printers is a vibration sensor. This printer can automatically calculate resonance, allowing for smooth surfaces even at high speeds. Changing the nozzle in the A1 is now much easier compared to older systems. For this, it is simply enough to remove the two bolts and the clip that holds the Heygen system in place. The printer comes with a 0.4 mm nozzle, but we can also use different sizes of nozzles depending on your purpose. We can also use 0.6 or 0.8 mm nozzles. The printer has wireless connectivity. You can send printing jobs using the Bambu Studio from your computer and the Bambu Handy application from your phone and tablet. You can change the various basic configurations of your printing, keep an eye on it in real time with the camera, or capture different time-lapse videos. On the right side of the printer, there is a small touch screen. The touch sensitivity of the screen is no different from that of a phone, and the Bambu Lab interface has been greatly simplified to allow you to use the printer comfortably. The A1 series entered the market with two models, A1 and A1 Combo. All the features I mentioned apply to the standard model. What makes the A1 a combo is the AMS light system. Thanks to this system, you can achieve multicolor printing with your printer without the need for painting. The features of the printer are quite nice. It has every feature expected from a new model 3D printer. In fact, it seems like there are some features that go beyond the standards we now expect from Bambu Lab. Of course, to test how good these features are, I took many printings with various materials. Let's continue the review with the first test printings right away. We start with a benchy test. The layers are very nice. There is no sagging in unsupported areas. There is only a very slight amount of stringing. Other than that, I don't see any issues. Honestly, this level of stringing can't even be considered a problem. The second printing is also a benchy, but it's a version that has been attacked by this giant octopus. Just like with the standard benchy, there is no problem with this model either. A very successful printing. I mentioned in the technical specifications that the A1 has automatic bed leveling. This is one of the best ways to test this feature, is to take large prints spread across the bed. I achieved this by printing a model that I could both test and use functionally. I had a spoolless filament from Bambu Lab. You can purchase bamboo filaments this way, use spools from previous filaments, or like I did, print a spool with your printer. As you can see, it was quite a large printing and there was not a single problem, even in the smallest detail. Both parts of the spool were printed flawlessly. In another printing, I wanted to test the printer for a longer period and printed this Wolverine helmet. Honestly, it was a very difficult printing because the yellow part starts printing from two separate points and merges with the main body and the nose part at a certain height. Here, even a very small deviation in the Z-axis would cause the nozzle to hit the part, and this part would detach from the bed. I especially supported the front part nicely and took the printing without any issues. Since the yellow part is textured, it's difficult to evaluate the surface quality. That is, there is no problem on the surface. However, this situation is the opposite with the black parts. Here we can see the surface quality very clearly. I think the result is quite good. In this long printing, there were no problems that I could call printing errors. Another detail I liked was the small perforated parts where the eyes are. It is difficult to print such finely detailed parts with FDM. Resin printers are generally preferred. However, this printing also came out successfully with almost no structural distortion. I also printed Wolverine's claws. I didn't like the model very much. It was a bit small and didn't fit my hand perfectly. But the printing quality is nice. Despite being long parts, there are no defects or nozzle marks on either the bottom surface or the top surface. From the speed and color test, this is the last printing I did with PLA. Let's look at the printings I did with ABS and PETG. What you see are the inner and outer body parts of a mouse. The gray one was printed with ABS and the blue parts were printed with PETG. Bambu has a wireless mouse kit like this, and you can print mouse bodies with very different designs and use them with your computer. The printing I did with ABS was not an easy model. It consists of extensions that rise separately, merge at certain points, and interlock. Or long parts that are both very thin and printed without support, like the right and left buttons. I think we can see the effects of these difficulties on the printing. There are layer lines and slight vibration effects at a few points. Still, I can say that the printing is not bad, and that the overall surface quality is good aside from these lines. The PETG parts are quite successful. Only one part shows very slight vibration effects near the hole. Other than that, all surfaces are nice. The part where the electronic components will fit has very thin and small pieces. These have come out quite clearly. Additionally, the absence of stringing on both ABS and PETG parts is also a good result. Now I'm also testing the A1 Mini Combo along with the A1 Combo. In my next video, you will be able to watch the review of the A1 Mini Combo as well. For that video, I got a nice model car printing and made the wheels with flexible TPU filament. The printing of two of these wheels was done with the A1 Combo, and the printing of the other two was done with the A1 Mini Combo. I thought it would give me a chance to compare the two printers in terms of TPU. There will be comparison videos for it later, but for now, let's just look at these printings I got with the A1. Bambu Lab X1 Carbon was the only 3D printer I used for speed testing with TPU. Because the printer is a TPU monster, it was possible to obtain a surface quality indistinguishable from PLA. I will say something similar for the A1. Printing with TPU using the A1 is very easy, and the print quality is quite successful. Now we come to the AMS light system. As you can see, you can attach four filaments to the AMS light. You can take colorful printings with the filaments you attach. When one filament runs out, it can continue printing with another. I don't know how practical it would be to use multiple materials on a single printing head, but it might be preferable even just for the use of support materials. Of course, it should not be forgotten that frequently changing different materials through a single printing head can cause clogs. I conducted a long-term test with AMS and did the printing of this model. You might say, is this the long-term test? Yes. Because the printing took exactly 18 hours and 30 minutes. This duration is quite long because there was a color change in almost every layer. However, despite multiple color changes, there are no defects on it. It is an extremely beautiful printing. Printing time aside, AMS also has the disadvantage of the amount of filament it uses. To print the model you see here, 252 grams of filament were used for color changes, while the model itself is only 49 grams. Of course, even if you print 10 of these models at the same time instead of one, the amount of filament used for color changes does not change, so the consumption rate per unit decreases. Therefore, in color printings, if needed, and if the printing area is sufficient, it makes more sense to do multiple printings. If we had done the same printing in a single color, the printing time would have been reduced from 18 hours and 30 minutes to 3 hours and 30 minutes, and the amount of extra filament used would have been just this much. With the AMS system, it is possible to do printing interesting models like tables in addition to three-dimensional models. This is the main character of the legendary movie Beetlejuice. In fact, the second movie is currently in theaters, and I am incredibly curious about it. I will definitely watch it as soon as possible. This decorative picture is quite fun. Also, since there is no constant color change, the extra filament waste is only as much as you see here. So, in my opinion, the higher the filament consumption and printing time in such a model, the more reasonable level it is for this type of model. If you try to paint something like this by hand, it would take more time and the cost of the paint wouldn't be much different from a handful of filament. Of course, as I mentioned, this situation also varies according to the number of color changes to be made during printing, and we are in the speed tests. As in every fast printer review, I printed the same model at speeds of 50, 150, 250, and 500 millimeter per second. Of course, reaching the maximum speed on models like this is not very easy. Factors like acceleration, filament flow rate, or cooling can limit you. However, I pushed the device from the softest printing to the most aggressive printing by increasing the speed and acceleration as much as possible. It is important to use filaments with high flow rates for fast printing. In this test, I used CCF's new product, Hyper PLA filament. The model you see is the Scorpion character from the Mortal Kombat game. The bust consists of two parts, the base and the main body. Now let's place these parts side by side and look at their differences. When we look at the base, it's hard to see the differences between the speeds. Still, the printing that appears the softest and smoothest was done at a speed of 50 millimeters per second, while the surfaces of the others are rougher. When we look at the top of the circular part, no nozzle mark is noticeable. However, at a speed of 600 millimeters per second, very small gaps started to form. This is not a significant error. I will say similar things within the body. 50 millimeters per second speed is a perfect surface. You can feel the vibration effect slightly at other speeds, but this increase is very minimal and the prints are generally quite nice. On the side of the bust, however, the effect of speed is a bit more noticeable. At least, aside from the vibration effects, I can see that there are more sags in a right-angled section of the clothing. The same situation is also present under the chin. I used support in this part, but again, as the speed increased, the sags also increased. As everywhere else, it is not very easy to see the effects of speed on the face. There is almost no difference at speeds of 50 and 150 mm per second. However, at speeds of 250 and 500 mm per second, I can see 1 to 2 layer lines on the mask. The point where I noticed the vibration effects the most was on the side of the head. I can say that there is no vibration effect at a speed of just 50 mm per second here. At all speeds after that, the vibration effects continued and were quite noticeable. Considering how much the printing time has been reduced, I can say that the deterioration in surface quality is at a reasonable level, and in some points, even very good results were achieved. A1 was the first Bambu Lab printer I used after the X1 Carbon. I don't want to compare it with the X1 Carbon, but my expectations were high, and it clearly met those expectations. Overall, the printing quality is very successful for a 3D printer. Apart from one or two points in the ABS and speed tests, I did not encounter any problems. I don't want to exaggerate too much, but I think the results are close to the X1 Carbon. AMS Lite is nice, but I still have some doubts about it. It consumes a lot of material and significantly extends the printing time. If you absolutely need to do color printing and can't bother with painting, then fine. But other than that, I'm not sure if I would get it just to continue with a finished filament or to use support material. I'll use this system a bit more and share my new experiences with you on my Instagram page. I'll also add the link to my Instagram page in the description below. The cooling is quite good and I haven't encountered any stringing or sagging problems. Despite having a powerful fan that does its job, I can also say that the A1 is one of the quietest printers I've used. In my tests, at a speed of 50 mm per second, the noise level was around 52 dB with the fan on, and it dropped to 45.5 dB when the fan was turned off. Even when the speed increased to 300 mm per second, there was not much change in the results. Aside from occasional noise spikes, I achieved the same results at 300 mm per second speed as I did at 50 mm per second speed. The camera is not good. At least when compared to the X1C's camera, it is quite poor in quality. Therefore, it can only be used to monitor the printing status. If you have dreams of capturing a time lapse and sharing it on Instagram, I recommend using another camera for recording. If you are going to use TPU filament, it is quite good. I achieved very good results with filaments of 95A hardness. However, be aware that you cannot use flexible filaments in the AMS system. The bed leveling system works very well. I can say clearly that I did not encounter the slightest defect and it performs bed leveling quite quickly. I might even say it is faster than the X1 Carbon. When this printer was released, it had some issues. So much so that Bambu Lab had to recall all the A1s worldwide. However, I see that these issues have been resolved and a beautiful, stable printer has been produced. That's all I have to say about the A1 Combo. I hope this has been a useful video for you and has given you some ideas. How did you find this video and the printing? I look forward to your comments. May your printer be trouble-free and your printings flawless. See you in the next video. Goodbye.